The NEC championship game is quickly approaching, and Coach, we want to thank you for taking a few minutes to sit down with us and welcoming us into your home gym here.
Appreciate it. Thanks, Craig, for having me.
Now, this is your first year as the head coach with LIU Brooklyn, and it's an interesting situation because usually when there's a new coach, it's because the team hasn't been doing well, but Right. You come in Yeah. And take over a team that's won back-to-back championships, Right. And obviously you've been there, so there's familiarity. So how much did you balance inserting your own style versus not messing up what you have?
Well, I mean, when you have as much success as we've had over the past 2 years, there wasn't a whole lot to change, especially when you had a group of guys coming back. We had
Right. We
had six seniors coming back and a junior, Jason Brickman, who was like a senior. So, not a whole lot was going to be changed. Certainly our offensive philosophy was the same, and defensively we were going to be the same as well.
Now, you didn't get a chance to kind of ease into anything because early on in the season there were a lot of roadblocks coming along the way, suspensions, injuries, losses, 0-3 in conference. So
Right. How
did you manage to get over all that and get here today, getting ready for the championship?
I'm not really sure. You look back, it was such a lot. You know, I had said originally, thank God it's a marathon and not a sprint, because you know when we had the issue on campus with the guys and we had injuries to Booker Hucks and Kenny Onyechi, we didn't even have a preseason. I had five guys and we were doing a little bit of individual work and that was pretty much it. So then we have we struggle out of the gates. We start to play well finally when everybody gets healthy and in shape. And then, boom, Julian Boyd goes down. And so then we got to reinvent ourselves again. So, you know, it's a credit to our guys. They really bought in and we got better defensively and guys adjusted to their new roles. And once they did that, you know, we started taking off from there. But it was real exciting once that happened, and obviously, hopefully, we can keep it going.
Now, you had a player of the year go down, but then you had another player of the year emerge in Jamal Olasuwer. How special of a season has he had this year?
Well, he's a special player. And we always said, even going in, Julian was the player of the year, but Jamal was first team all league last year as well, and he's just a special player. He's unique. He's a mismatch for anybody in the league and anybody in the country, to be honest with you. He's got a unique ability to get fouled and really put pressure on the defense. So he's really stepped his game up even more so, being the focal point of everybody's defense. And he's really adjusted to that nicely, obviously being considered the player of the year, and he's been great for us.
Now, when you look to Mount St. Mary's, look at the game tape, what stands out about them? What have they been doing well these last nine games that they've won en route to the final here?
They've been awesome. They've been awesome. We were part of that nine games when we went down there and struggled against them. Defensively, they just really get after you, obviously. They put so much pressure on you and take you out of what you want to do and out of your comfort level. So that's where it starts. That's where it begins on that end. We got to do a good job of taking care of the basketball and not letting them dictate the tempo that way. On the defensive end of things for us, you know, their transition, they really push the ball and are aggressive on the offensive end and really like to fire threes. So we got to take away those threes. First, we got to get back, and Right. Then we got to take away those threes and be aggressive that way. And then they set a ton of ball screens. They're very similar to us that way. So we got to handle those ball screens well and not let them create for others that way.
And have you had a chance to chat with Coach Ferry at all recently? Has he given you any advice?
You know what? I spoke with him the day after, and obviously, he's a very good friend of mine, and he's a great resource for me. And you know, all the same stuff. You know, we've always talked. We basically have the same philosophy and everything. So we just communicated that way, and he said, "Hey, anything you need, I'll be there for you." So,
now, Coach, I'll get you out of here on this last one. You know, whenever fans, people who follow sports, you know, talk about greatest teams ever, greatest runs ever. It's always a subjective argument. Right. But for LIU Brooklyn, during this current run you're on right now, if you win on Tuesday night, it would be third straight championship. No team's ever done that before. Nine straight tournament wins. No team's ever done that before. So the evidence would suggest that in NEC it would be LIU Brooklyn. Would you agree with that evidence if you would win on Tuesday night?
I certainly would. And that was kind of the thing the carrot that I threw out to the guys when I first got the job. Like, hey, you know, this is something that we can do and we can claim because nobody's ever done it before. And you're talking about so many guys that have been here throughout it. It's not like there's been a whole lot of turnover. So, yeah, I think that, you know, absolutely 100%. If we can pull this off, tonight, then we'll be considered the best ever.
Well, Coach, thank you for joining us and best of luck against Mount St. Mary's.
Thanks, Craig. Appreciate it.